You know what? We forget that the other team wants to play too, and we got a long change, and they pushed, and we weathered the storm, and you know the guys stuck together, but they played hard. They're NHL players. They're trying to play too, and yeah, we weren't happy with our second period. We addressed it in between the second and third. We tried to address it on the bench. That we had to simplify our game, get pucks deep, not give them momentum, don't turn the puck over. I mean, we not only the coaches were talking like that, the players were talking like that. So, we got away with the game not getting away from us, and we were able to regroup in the second and third. And we thought we played a terrific third period, and first period was real good. So we're going to take a lot of positives.
To see a guy like Victor Rask, Alex Galchenyuk, who had a tough game yesterday, come up with the big goals there, how just big was that in the third?
Awesome. I mean, it's tough to score in this league. And for Victor Rask to be out however many games he was out and then come back and score a goal, it's great. I mean, it's the best league in the world, and to perform like he did. His faceoffs, I think, after the second period were 5 or 6, 7-0. So, I mean, like he's done the right things, clearly, off the ice and in practice to set himself up to play well.
One win trip versus a two win trip, Dean, going into this break when you're going to watch a lot of teams play while you sit idle. I mean, how crucial was that swing?
You know what? It was wonderful to get the win tonight. We talked to the group about, winning in different ways. The San Jose game, different way we won. Tonight, different way. Hopefully we can put all these in the memory bank going forward, because we're going to have to play extremely well in a lot of different ways to have success. So we'll take some time off to rest here and get back at it.
Dean, just how big of a spark has Cunning brought to you since he got back in the lineup? Obviously a huge play on the overtime winner.
Yeah. Again, like we talked about it before the game, about his versatility. He played wing tonight. He's played center last game even, and he's flipping around, and he's a valuable player to us. Plays a strong game, plays a steady game. You can chip in offensively. It's a bonus.
Was there a debate back during the second intermission about maybe pulling Dubnyk
No.
Just for him to rebound the way he did in the third period?
Yeah, 100%. He battled. He battled his butt off. Same thing. He hasn't been in the net for a while, and it's a tough, bloody league to play in. And he battled for his team tonight, and I think his team battled for him.
We talked a lot about the evolution of Kevin Fiala, but as part of that development, bouncing back from a bad game like he did, limiting it to one bad game and then carrying the team tonight like he did.
Well, we've talked a lot about Kevin and how he's competed, even the nights that he's not scoring, like tonight obviously he scored, but the nights that he's not scoring, he's busting his butt in different areas. That's all we can ask. He has the skill set to score, but when he's not, if he's doing the right things, he's going to help his team.
His teammates sound like they expect something good to happen when he's on the ice. Like, is that where your confidence is at too? Like, you send him over the boards for that face, in overtime, and, it's like, not a surprise.
Yeah, we try to get him out there as much as we possibly can.